Welcome to this very special edition of Inside the Heat. I am Jason Jackson. Our focus on an all-star who has participated in the great weekend of magical NBA excitement in each of his 9 NBA seasons. Of course, we're talking about LeBron James. In 2012, he was once again selected as an Eastern Conference All-Star, but that was just the last item on his to-do list in his manic 72 hours of participation. We begin as he approached the Player Hotel on All-Star Friday. LeBron, first of all, it's got to be great, as always, to start All-Star Weekend. But are they getting a little dense in the things that you have to get to versus the first time you started All-Star Weekend?
It's always exciting, man. I stay humble with this, knowing that you see all these fans around the hotel. These are the fans that voted me in. So I got to bring all the energy I got because they voted me in. So I'm very humble by it.
The Miami Heat had the most players represented on the court for the 2012 All-Star Weekend, and all of them realized the significant impact they leave off the court.
That's what it's about, get an opportunity to do some charitable work, of course, that, help people that's, not as privileged as us, but also, do some after-school programs with kids that's also trying to make it up in the ranks and let them know how important education is, but also the after-school activities.
We're going to day of service right now. Hey, it's time to go help some people out.
What's going on, buddy? How you doing, man? I like that. Firm handshake. I like that.
The All-Star Weekend is a chance to give back to communities all around the nation. So, before All-Star basketball begins, the All-Stars themselves give back. LeBron James and Chris Bosh helped move furniture and painted a mural for children.
How you doing, sweetheart? Good. Much better than me. They teaching me how to paint, ain't that right? Anna said that's right. I don't like messing up, so I'm like real precise. I don't like getting outside the lines and stuff. So
it just shows and gives testimony that they don't just care about the quality of what they do on the court, but the quality of what they do in the community as well.
The message was, I have three little guys that are walking into school and coming out, they're coming out as adults. I love it. I Rembrandt has got nothing on these guys.
You guys are doing a great job down there. That looks amazing.
You're doing good up there.
Thank you. I'm trying. I like your shades too. It was nice.
They participated in painting part of the mural, which is huge. They got with children. Many of those children are going through the crisis with their families of homelessness. And then, of course, they moved into the Learning Center and helped assemble furniture there.
We're totally transforming. We're painting Orlando Magic colors. We donated all this furniture.
Oh, somebody got the same shades I got. What y'all want to do with this couch right here? You want to put it over here? Come on, man. You guys welcome. Just brought our strength in here. But this is where they made the food and everything.
This is where they made the food. They serve the food. And this is where the homeless men sleep every night. It's first come, first serve basis. They get a mat. They sleep between the yellow lines here. And then they also serve them food every night. So they serve over 500 men a night.
After seeing the homeless shelter, LeBron and Chris put food and care packages together for the homeless.
What a great boost for morale for somebody who is looking for a job and opens up this package and sees a note from Chris Bosh or from LeBron James. There's nothing like that to affirm the fact that even during tough times, people who do the right thing get rewarded.
You gotta go with the apple cinnamon. He's a what we call a perfectionist. If he had enough time, he'd write a book and put it inside the package. If he had enough time. And to be able to put smiles on kids' faces and families' faces, don't get no better than that for me. So, I don't do it to say I had an impact on them. I just do it because I enjoy it, and what comes out of it comes out of it. So, to be in my position to be able to have the opportunity to be able to paint a mural or, make these gift packages for these families and things like that, I'm humbled by it and I'm blessed to be able to do it. But I don't really care about the benefits that I get out of it. It's all about the families and the kids.
With a lighthearted spirit, LeBron is always wanting to put smiles on faces.
What's going on, officer? All right. Go ahead and put a little smile on your face. Good things going on in here. Got to look so mean.
They even ran into someone special.
Putting in some good work. We just got done painting, opening some boxes. It's all good.
Thanks for helping out.
Oh, yeah, always. I love you too, girl. But it's been a good day, though. This stuff right here is amazing to be able to give back to a community, underprivileged people, underprivileged kids and families. I mean, it's amazing. I love it.
Who better to judge a dunk contest than the dunk master himself? LeBron posted up as a judge for the Sprite Uncontainable campaign.
Well, being here with the slam dunk competition and Sprite put together, you see these athletes around the world that compete and show their excitement above the rim as well. So to be a judge for that, to be able to give out the award for the winner, that was great.
Although he crowned the champion, an upcoming slam dunk contestant might be on the rise. LeBron's kids stood close by with their father to watch the All-Star festivities, and they were excited to see some other All-Stars they looked up to as well. Getting from one event to another can be a mission for LeBron. But his jam-packed day continued as he coached possible future All-Stars.
How nice is it to have the boys with you? As they get a little bit older, they can kind of remember, they can participate, they can see, they can show us that they have the genes already with a nice smooth jumper motion.
It's exciting to have them around with the schedule that we have. You don't get to be around your family a lot, so in a moment like this where it's about all the stars, it's about all the fans, and it's about family, to have my boys here and to be able to take it in as well, it's great. Because I don't have a case for my iPod, so I'm going to, you know, since it is my store, I might as well invest in it.
While you're global, while you are national, you also are doing some things local. Tell us a little bit about your store up at Aventura Mall.
Oh, man, it's been great since it opened. And it just gives an opportunity for young adults, kids to come by, the shoes, the clothes, everything that they love, be able to come in there and either, you know, purchase the stuff or just explore the store.
Are you happy with the LeBron James enterprises outside of basketball?
I'm ecstatic. I'm so ecstatic, I don't even put lenses in my shades anymore.
Boop. LeBron loves having fun, but he takes fundraising for kids seriously.
LeBron, we discussed on many occasions the difficulty of your childhood, and I imagine that connects directly. Now, you emerged from it nicely. Obviously, basketball was the key, but if you didn't have that, would you have needed a program like this?
Absolutely. You know, the after-school's all-star program, you know, the boys and girls clubs, all the recreation clubs, I would have definitely needed. You need mentors in your life, you know, beyond your parents, you know, teachers, you know, basketball or sports coaches or whatever the case may be, to help you believe that your dream can become a reality.